Hello everyone, welcome back to the channel. In this video, we're gonna see how to easily create this double exposure that you can see in here using Adobe Photoshop. Alright, so let's go and open Photoshop, and then I will go and open the image I will be using. Alright, so the first thing that we are going to do is to cut out the model from the background. So I will go to select and choose subject. Now we have a really decent selection, but I want to include these eyelashes. So I will go back to select and choose select and mask. And then I will use the refined edge to actually try to improve those eyelashes a little bit. Maybe some parts of these flying hairs. And in here too. Alright, so I think we have a really nice selection. Now we'll just put a little bit of smooth, maybe 6, and then we press OK. Alright, now I'm gonna apply a layer mask, and then I will add a solid color, and I will leave it white, and then I will put it below our model layer, and then I will go and open the image that we're gonna use as a double exposure. So this will be our double exposure image, which is just trees. I really like the tree double exposure because I think it's a very cool looking with the branches and everything. Now you can leave like this if you want in a horizontal way, but for me I'm gonna flip it like this because I want this double exposure to be like this. So yeah, it's up to you, you can choose whatever you want. I will make sure to put a link where you can find this tree image. I think it's a really nice image. It works very good for double exposure. You can use the same technique and you will end up with different results every time you do that. All right, so let's choose like a good position because I want this actually to be maybe merged with the mouth. It's like this, and also I want a part of the tree that it will be looking natural from here. So yeah, I'm just trying to find that sweet spot. I like the branches that they are coming from here. So yeah, I think I will keep it around here. Little bit down, yeah. So for me I think it's okay like this. So I will one click on this check mark and then I will zoom out and I will put back the opacity to 100%, and then I will change the blending mode of these trees to screen, and I will name these trees, and there we go, we are already starting looking really cool. As you can see, this is quite cool because we have almost the perfect combination with those two images. All right, so I want to emphasize this a little bit more. And to do that, I'm just gonna create another copy of the tree layer by pressing Ctrl Command J. And then I will change the blending mode of it to normal. And I will apply a black layer mask by pressing Alt or Option and one click. And then using a soft round brush, 0% hardness, maybe I will put down the flow to like 5%, and I will go to the edges and I will start painting using white just to show those branches even more, just like that. That idea is to have the branches looking like they are coming from our model or from the side of this portrait. Maybe I will put up the flow for like 12 and let's see. Yeah, I think I'm happy with this. Now I will go back to the other tree layer, and this time I will add a layer mask, a normal layer mask, and I will use black this time to remove some of the details that we have on the model. For example, in the eyes, maybe a little bit in here to see the eye, and a little bit from the mouth. just to have that blending looking a little bit more cooler and natural. Yeah, I think this is looking really cool. Now I think I'm gonna crop this a little bit. Maybe I would put it a little bit smaller, maybe like a square. Yeah, something like that. All right, so we're almost done. Now we only need to add a little bit of adjustment. So I like to add a gradient map. So I will go select the first layer that we have in here, and I will go to adjustment and choose gradient map. As you can see, it looks really cool, black and white too. So that's another option. But for me, I think I want a little bit of colors. So I will open the gradient and I will one click on this black stop. And let's actually choose that sepia kind of vintagey color for this. Yeah, maybe something like this. And then I will go to the white color stop. And for this one, I will go for something bluish or cyan. Yeah, maybe, yeah, something like this. I think it looks interesting. And maybe I will go back and I will make this a little bit brighter. Exactly what I want, like this. All right, now I will change the blending mode of this to exclusion, and I will put down the fill to 0, and I will go a little bit up to see perfect number, maybe 20% for this. You just can see how the color got muted a little bit. I think this is looking good. All right, now I think I'm gonna apply a camera raw filter for this. So to do that, I will merge everything, or I will make a stand visible layer by just pressing Ctrl Shift Alt E all together, or Command Shift Option E all together. And this will take basically a screenshot of what we have in our canvas. And let's call this raw, and then I will right click, convert it to smart object. Then I will go to filter and choose camera raw filter. All right, so let's mess with the lights a little bit. Let's go to the exposure and see what we have. And maybe I will put down the exposure a little bit to like minus 0.5 or 0.4. So let's go minus 0.3. And I think we are doing good with the contrast. So we'll go to the colors. And let's add a little bit of warm to this. Maybe more yellow. And a little bit of green. And let's put down the saturation a little bit, and maybe a little bit more of the vibrance. All right, I think it looks really nice. Maybe more down the saturation like this. All right, cool. Now I will add a little bit of a vignette, just like this, minus 50 or 60. And a little bit of grain, like 5 or 6. And I will press OK. And that will be our effect. So let's see before and after. This is before, and this is after. All right, so I hope that you enjoy and you like this tutorial, and it was a little bit helpful for you. Don't forget to subscribe and comment, and you know where for more to come. And have a nice day. Thank you for watching.